Please don't forget that in 1975, it was the patriarch of the National Conference himself, Sheikh Abdullah, who virtually gave up all this 1953, pre-53, pre-autonomy. No, I'm talking of...
The demand is a legitimate one.
I'm just reminding him of what his father said. He got himself reinstated as the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, never made a fuss about pre-53, never made a fuss about autonomy. On the contrary, just to get over it, he set up a committee called Devidas Thakur Committee to look into the provisions of Indian Constitution which had been extended to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. This committee comes out with certain conclusions, submits a report and says that all the provisions of the Indian Constitution, including the Supreme Court of India, the Election Commission of India, etc., etc., are for the benefit of the people of the state. And Sheikh Abdullah happily and readily accepts that. Few years later, Farooq Abdullah comes out with another autonomy resolution when he was, to be fair to him, the Chief Minister. The report is rejected by the central government. He conveniently sleeps over it, continues as the Chief Minister. His son continues as the junior minister in the union government. Had they been so committed to the idea of autonomy, could they have at least, as a token, offered their resignation so that they could prove their credibility to the people of Kashmir? What I'm trying to say is, in a nutshell, that there are a certain Kashmir-centric political groups and politicians. When in power, they swear by Kashmir being an integral part of India. When out of power, they start raising question marks. They are actually not following their own dictum by conviction. It's more out of convenience to actually hoodwink the people of Kashmir.
But sir, let me remind you that...